Hey, Stargazers, welcome back. My name is Nick. I'm a theaters manager at the Adler Planetarium, and you're watching Skywatch Weekly. Well, this week, all the news is about the Great Conjunction of Jupiter and Saturn. So we'll be talking all about that. I'll give you my number one piece of advice for viewing this conjunction. But first, I do want to take a brief moment to say thank you. During this season of giving, the Adler Planetarium is looking to raise $50,000 by the end of the year to help support our online programming. Special thanks to four shining stars who helped us get closer to that goal this week. John Coletta, Kelly Mote, Bruce Davidson, and Joseph Gall. Thank you. You're helping us connect more people to the universe and to one another. If you're interested in donating and want to get a shout out in a future episode, click the link at the end of this video. All right, so the Great Conjunction, or maybe the Grand Conjunction, or the super amazing, no one's ever seen this before, conjunction. Whatever you want to call it, this meeting of Jupiter and Saturn in the evening sky is actually kind of a big deal. Now, whether you've been looking forward to it for a long time, or you just heard about it and clicked on this video wondering what's up, let's dive right in and see what's happening. Long story short, on the evening of Monday, December 21st, Saturn and Jupiter will appear closer in the sky than they have in centuries. How close? To give an idea of the scale, they're separated by roughly one-fifth the width of the full moon in the sky, just one-tenth of a degree. Put it another way, hold up a dime and turn it edge on, and then hold it at arm's length. The thickness of the dime is how close they'll be. Now keep in mind, they're not actually all that close in space. They just appear close in our sky. In fact, Saturn is about half a billion miles farther than Jupiter right now. Jupiter orbits the Sun once every 12 years, and Saturn takes 30 years. So every 20 years or so, Jupiter catches up with and passes Saturn in its orbit. These conjunctions of Jupiter and Saturn have historically been called Great Conjunctions, mainly because they're bright planets and it's a very eye-catching event. Other conjunctions occur all the time. The term conjunction basically means two objects are close together in the sky. This could be the moon and a planet, or the moon and a star, occasionally a planet and a star, or two planets quite close. But not all great conjunctions are equal. Because of differences in the tilt of their orbits, Saturn and Jupiter don't usually look all that close during conjunctions. That's what makes this year's extra great. So how rare is this for them to get so close in the sky? Well, let's go back to July 16th, 1623. That's the last time Jupiter and Saturn appeared as close as they will on Monday. Now, believe it or not, probably no one saw this happen in 1623. Jupiter and Saturn would have been almost impossible to spot in the twilight glow because they were so close to the Sun from our point of view. Let's go back even farther to March 4th, 1226. That's almost 800 years ago. If you had been up before dawn that morning, you would have seen Jupiter and Saturn about as close as they will be on Monday. Keep in mind though, no one was looking through telescopes back then. So truly, no one alive has seen Jupiter and Saturn this close in the sky. Full disclosure, some of you might have seen them almost this close. On February 19th of 1961, Jupiter and Saturn were almost this close together in the early morning sky. This time around, though, no need to get up early. But maybe do set an alarm or reminder to head out after sunset on the 21st and take a look. Our view here is looking southwest about 45 minutes after sunset on Monday, December 21st. This is probably the sweet spot for visibility, but I would recommend heading out basically right at sunset to catch the planets as early and as high above the horizon as possible. By an hour past sunset, they'll be a little over a fist's width above the horizon. The bright dot you see here is Jupiter, and just to its upper right is Saturn, which will be quite a bit dimmer. Just with your eyes, you should be able to see them both as distinct points, although at first it might look like one point of light. Remember, they're separated by the thickness of a dime held at arm's length. So, as long as you have clear skies, this will be visible to the naked eye. With binoculars, you'll easily split them and maybe get a view of Jupiter's moons for good measure. With a telescope, the view gets truly remarkable. In the field of view of a regular eyepiece on a backyard telescope, you'll be able to see both Jupiter and Saturn, along with the Galilean moons and Saturn's rings, all in the same view. That's amazing. But here's the thing. As cool as the view will be on Monday night, we all know we can't rely on the sky to be clear when we need it to be. So here's my number one piece of advice, and I haven't heard this a lot of places. Don't wait until Monday night to go out and see Jupiter and Saturn. In fact, don't even wait until Sunday night. Go out tonight or the next night it's clear at sunset and check them out. Sure, naked eye, they won't be as close as they will be on Monday night, but it's still a beautiful pairing of bright objects in the sky. In fact, tonight, December 16th, they'll be joined by a beautiful crescent moon. And if you want to catch that incredible telescope view, it's already happening. I got a very brief break in the clouds two nights ago and got this view with a low-power eyepiece and my backyard scope. Yeah, it's not the best astrophoto I've ever taken, but the views with my eyes through the eyepiece were incredible. Two giant planets in the same field of view. And even in this picture, you can see some moons of Jupiter and the shape of Saturn's rings. So it's already happening. Jupiter and Saturn are already closer in the sky than they will be for another 60 years. And check this out. This is a simulated eyepiece view from the Stellarium app. The red circle on the screen is a half-degree field of view, about the apparent width of the moon. That's a higher magnification than I was using for my picture. But with this amount of magnification, you'll be able to see both Jupiter and Saturn in the same telescope view starting tomorrow night, December 17th. They'll get closer and closer each night until Monday for their closest approach. But even after that, all the way until Christmas Eve, they'll still be in this same telescopic field of view. And if your eyepiece gives a wider field of view than just the moon, you'll be able to see this even longer. So seriously, especially if you have a telescope and you want to see this amazing view of two planets in the same field of view, do not wait until Monday. December's weather is fickle, and I would hate for someone to miss this event thinking it was Monday or nothing. It certainly isn't. And hey, if you get lucky and it's clear on Monday as well, that's great. You'll be more prepared and ready to marvel at this historic event. Well, for even more about conjunctions, and hopefully even live views of this one, tune in to Adler's Sky Observers Hangout on Monday, December 21st at 5 p.m. Central Time. Michelle and Adriana from Adler's Public Observing Team will cover it all and answer your questions live. Weather and technology permitting, Michelle will be showing live views of the conjunction through her telescope, so it'll be a truly memorable experience. Definitely check it out and all of the great live shows they do over there at Sky Observers Hangout. Well, that's what we have for you this week. Thanks, as always, for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to Adler's YouTube channel for more great content, and also follow along on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. Enjoy the conjunction, and we'll see you next week.